Good morning, Longview.
Good morning.
I didn't hear all of y'all, so I'm gonna ask one more time. Good
morning,
Longview. Good
morning.
Thank you. I'm again very honored to be back up on this podium, as I did this alone this time. It wasn't the easiest since I didn't get to help or get the help with my mom. And I couldn't get help by anyone else because all my family are mothers.
Just like myself, so I'm like, okay. And then of course I have my many mothers in the church, like Miss late Ms. Teresa Bryant, who is my Sabbath school teacher. She taught me so much. So I'm like, okay, let me just pick a pull from a little of everybody. I joke with my grandmother today about how I hope I'm not the reason she has arthritis in her knees, because she prayed for me so much as a child. I was diagnosed with asthma at the age of like 7 years old, and I always had like constant asthma attacks, panic attacks, and everything. And I could be like in the ambulance getting like CPR or something, and my grandmother's like, "Don't close the ambulance door. Let me drop down to my knees and pray for this baby." And today I don't struggle with anything. So my mother is the baby girl of the family of 11 kids, and I'm her only child. And for a long time, I thought that, I knew what I was taught in the church as far as, okay, just pray for everything. But it took my mom to show me like the struggles and actually showing me how, when you talk to God, the steps that he's working out for you. And because I could be like, okay, my mother never let me see her struggle. But as I got older and became a mother myself, that's when I was able to realize, okay, God is already knowing that, okay, you're about to go through a little bit of struggle, but he already planned out the great outcome for you. And so it took my mother to show me that strength. And I'm like, mommy, okay, why didn't you tell me that you had this deal, or you trying to send me all these field trips? And she's like, that's not your problem. She said, it's not my problem either. God got me. So between all of my many different mothers in the church and outside of the church, I was just always taught that nothing is too big for God. Nothing is too hard for God. And all you have to do is just trust on him, trust in him, talk to him. He knows the problem. He just needs you to tell him and just ask him for help, because he's got it already. So it was a privilege for me growing up and still growing up. I'm only 24. I got a long way to go, especially with that little boy back there, as many of you know. So just being able to watch my mother constantly, as well as my grandmother, show me to, above all else, just trust in God and ask him for the help that I need. I can do all things through him.
With eyes closed and heads bowed, Father in heaven, nothing my hands I bring, but simply to the cross I cling. Hide me behind your cross, so as I share my testimony today, it will draw someone close to you. In Jesus' name, amen. So I too was asked to share my testimony, what Mama taught me about God. Growing up in the Caribbean, Mama taught me a lot of things. She taught me how to cook, how to clean, how to do some gardening. She even taught me what to look for in a man when I'm looking for a husband. Not that I listened to her. But anyway, Mama taught me a lot of things. But what did Mama taught me about God? There's so many. I just touched on a few today. Mama taught me to give. My mother is one of the most giving person I've ever met. She has always taught us, you've never have too little that you can share with others. Right. Now when I visit her back in the Caribbean, being a third world country, coming from a developed country, I would take items to her. Sometimes I would take personal items, because not that you can get it there, but it's very expensive. I would take, she has specific deodorants she likes to use and specific toothpaste and stuff. And I would just load up and take stuff to her. After a few weeks, I would speak to her. She sent it to buy these things. Mom, where are all the deodorants? Where are all this, where that? Well, I gave it to such and such. Such and such came to visit, and I gave it. And I said, that's not for you to give, you're shut in. You have to keep these items at home with you. I would send house dresses. Mama would give them away. She would be sharing. So that's one of the things that Mama taught me to give. She always reminds us that we are to give just as God the Father gave his only begotten Son. Just as Jesus Christ himself gave his life for us, so we too are to give. Another thing Mama taught me about God is how to forgive. She would always say, you have to forgive 70 times 7. And growing up, that kind of baffled me. My mom had, you know, quite a few friends, and she would, when she has a friend, she goes all out for her friends. And she's had some who has betrayed her, who has really hurt her. And I would see as time goes by, these same friends, she would be baking for them, she would be sewing. I said, Mom, did such and such for you? You still doing this for her? And she said, I'll give her up to God. You just have to pray for her. And she always tells us that if someone wrongs you, pray for them. Because while you are praying, you cannot have an ill thoughts about that person. Lead them up to God. So Mama taught me about God to forgive. Just like God the Father forgives us daily, we too have to forgive others. Mama also taught me how to pray, or the power of prayer. Now, some of you may know that recently I had the privilege to drop everything here in Memphis, fly to the Caribbean, to spend two full months with my mom. She has some health challenges, which she still does. And, you know, I dropped everything and went and spent that time with her. And she would get up every morning before the sun comes out. Between 5 and 5:30 in the morning, I would hear her pray. She would get out of bed. She uses a walker. She would get out of bed. She would be in a chair in her room. And she would be praying. And she prays for all her children. She prays for the family. She prays for the country, for the leaders. She prays for the church family. Mama taught me the power of prayer. She taught us how to pray. And just as Jesus would wake early in the morning away from the other disciples and go aside and pray the same way my mom does, even up to this day, she also would pray late in the evening. Our son, whether we have guests at the house, she would step aside. She's back in the bedroom in her chair. I call it her prayer chair. She would get in her chair, and I would hear her pray aloud. And I thank God for that example of my mom praying. I also remember when I was in college, and I have an exam to take. I would be outside the room waiting to enter to take my test, and I know that I didn't prepare for that test. I would dial mommy. Mommy, I have a test to take. It's very important. Please pray for me. Before she gets this, okay, she would just start praying immediately. And sometimes when I get my grade, I was like, God, thank you for praying, mother. You know, I know to myself that I didn't prepare for the test as I should have. And these are some of the things that Mama has taught me. Mama has also taught me how to be loving. How God himself is a loving Father to us. Nothing is too much for her to give any one of us. And what I love about her is that if she can give her hat, her last dollar to the first child, she can give it to any one of us. She doesn't have that favoritism. Although I think I'm her favorite, but. But Mama taught me how to be loving, just as God himself is a loving father to each and every one of us. This is what I learned from my mom also, how to be loving. And to sum it all up, if I am half the woman that my mom is, then I know I have accomplished something. My mom is the glue. She is what kept the family together. Like, we wouldn't even know that we didn't have anything to eat, but mommy would get something together. She would be there to protect us in a loving way, and I thank God for her. I also want to ask the church to remember her in prayer. She moves around with a walker, and she had a really bad fall on yesterday. So she's going through a lot of pain now and going to doctors and stuff. So please remember my mom in prayer, and this is all I have today.
Good afternoon, church. Jeremiah 29:12 says, "Then you will call on me and come and pray to me, and I will listen to you." Around 11 or 12 years old, I had to go and live with my grandmother because my mother was caught up in the world and she was doing things that kept her from being a mother to my sister and I. So my grandmother, Gloria James, raised my sister and I. And my grandmother and my dad would make sure I was in church every week. And I was in the band in school, and you know, my friends' parents, well, their mom would be there, and my dad would be there. My mom wasn't around, but my dad would make sure he was there for the parent conference and all that. And I miss having my mom around. One of those times, when you're a teenager growing up, she wasn't around. But my grandmother always made sure that I had what my sister and I had what we needed. But one thing about my mom, she would come and stay with my grandmother sometimes, but she would always tell my grandmother and I, make sure you pray for me. And I always remember that she believed in prayer. And she would all, no matter what she was doing out in the world, she would always tell us to pray for her. And she, once she was going through a whole lot, and I was praying for my mom, I was like, Lord, please don't let my mom die out in the world. And so once I got grown, I was, you know, my grandmother was, I was still staying with my grandmother. And once I got grown and I had Mark, and I had to depend on my mom to keep him while I was working, my mom started coming around. And I was praying for her all of this time to be there for me. But God had other plans. She wasn't there for me, but once I had my kids and my sister had my nephew, she started coming around and being the grandmother and mother to us and our kids. She would pick them up from school. She would feed them. She would have them all the time. She was a great grandmother to my kids, and I thank the Lord for that. And I was talking to her one day, and she told me, she said, I would always pray for my kids, and I always ask the Lord to not let me die. She was praying the same prayer I was praying, for her not to die out in the world. She was praying the same thing, Lord, don't let me die this way. And the Lord brought her back around, and she came out of the world. She didn't come to church, but she still had us pray. She still would tell us to pray for her. And so she told me, she said, once I had to start keeping Mark, I didn't want anybody coming around. I didn't want none of those people coming around him. And she said, if I could stay clean while I had my grandchild, then I can stay clean, period. And I thank the Lord for that. My mom, that meant a whole lot to me, that my children and her grandchildren, well, her grandchildren meant that much to her. And when I watched my mom, she came out of the world, but she got sick. And I was we were all at the hospital. She went into the hospital on her 50th birthday, and she stayed for 9 days. And I like to think that while my mom was in hospital, she was praying and asking the Lord to save her. And I believe to this day that my mom will be saved. And when I watched my mom take her last breath, it was devastating. And all of the family was there, and we were, hysterical, crying and everything, because it just came out of nowhere. And Pastor Owen started praying for us. And I felt something come over me. It was a calm feeling. It was like the Lord was wrapping me in his arms, telling me, it's going to be okay. You're going to make it. And I knew then, I said, I can't continue to play church. I have to get my life together. I couldn't imagine losing my mom. I was like, when she got herself together, I lost her, But I thank the Lord that she was able to come out of that life, because that's what we were praying for. And she was praying the same prayer. And I just thank God to this day. And I do believe that my mom will be saved. And the last thing I wanted to say is my grandmother, she has lost her third child. Just last week, she lost her third child. And my grandmother is still here. She's 86 years old. She's still trying to make it. And she's still praying for us. 86 years old, and she's strong here today. And she just lost her third child. She has to bear her third child, but I thank the Lord for her and for always making sure that me and my sister was here in church. And I just thank the Lord for that.
Thank everybody who's a part of our Mother's Day program. At this time, I want to do a little something special. And I want everybody to participate. When you think of your mother, what do you think of? I want one word. So when I think of my mother, I think of laughter. Somebody else? Stand up and tell me.
Smile.
Love.
Awesome.
Anybody else? But kind.
Giving.
Intelligent. Anybody else?
Give me,
come on.
Yeah.
Strong. You know, tree. Go on, some more.
Courageous.
Patient. Special. Patient. Some more. Serenity.
Calmness.
Come on, some more.
Warrior.
Loving.
Arise, shine, for your light is come, and the glory of the Lord rises upon you. The Lord will be your light, your everlasting light, and your God, your glory. Thank you, Lord. Please bow your heads for prayer. Heavenly Father, I come before you in your temple to give you praise, to give you honor, to give you glory. Lord, we thank you so much for everything that you do for us. We thank you for the plan of a family. Lord, we thank you for our mothers, whether they're here or sleeping in their graves, Heavenly Father. Lord, we love them. Lord, we thank you for blessing us and keeping us, Lord. We ask that you just watch over us and guide us and keep us humble enough to hear your still small voice. Watch over us and protect us throughout this week. Give us the meat, the nourishment, and the strength that we need to carry on your word, Heavenly Father.